I was just telling your sister. Father's been looking to make a match for me. And Talia's been such good company. Think she likes me? Or maybe your mother? A flower plucked is still a flower. Just dies more quickly. We could be a family, Lord Forrester. You'd like that, wouldn't you? Your mother may need some convincing.
You killed our brother.
I've killed many brothers. Sisters, too. But let's put our happy day to the side for a moment. Walk with me. Oh, you won't need your sword. Not where we're going.
I'm not going without my sword.
I'm afraid you are. Here, I'll help you. There. Doesn't that feel better? Oh, you're coming too.
This is Lord's business, not a child's.
I say she comes. I don't trust her with my men.
How fares your father, Lord Bolton?
Better than yours. Polite of you to ask. I loved playing in the woods when I was your age. Still do. So many places to hide. I've gotten very good at finding people.
Rodrik?
It's all right, Talia.
That reminds me. Where's Gryff? I expected to be greeted by him on my arrival. Bit of a disappointment to have to show myself in. And here I had such high hopes for Ludson.
Now should I know? Gryff and his men are not my concern.
My concerns are your concerns. I assume you forgot that when you took them prisoner. Oh, I really hoped things might be different with you. I hoped we could be friends. After all, I was generous. I've allowed you to keep half your forest. Your livelihood. Yet you went behind my back and called in the Glenmore. I'm not sure how he managed that. The Glenmores have sworn their loyalty to my father.
I knew I couldn't trust the Whitehills, so I asked the Glenmores to keep the peace.
You don't need the Glenmores. You have the protection of the Warden of the North. Well, I'm certainly glad we've sorted this out. Thank you for being so forthcoming. But there's still a price. Ah. Here we are.
Arthur!
Rodrik!
You disobeyed me. You disrespected me.
Please!
Someone has to pay! You didn't think it would be you, did you? Your damaged goods. Someone else's leftovers.
Arthur's done nothing wrong! If you want to hurt someone, hurt me!
No, Rodrik!
Why bother? You're nearly a corpse already.
No!
Stop!
Look at what you've done! I hope it was worth it.
Is it worth it, Arthur?
Please, stop! Please!
Talia, don't look away. It's very important you see what comes of disobedience.
Rodrik, make him stop! Please, do something!
You'll pay for this, Ramsey!
Please.
Look at him, Talia. See what your brother's done.
Please! Lord Ramsey.
Sorry, but they'll never learn otherwise.
Mercy, have mercy! Mercy, my lord!
Did Rodrik show mercy to Gryff? This is his fault. That's a lot of blood.
I'll see you dead for this!
And that, Talia, is why no one likes your brother. Poor lad's fainted. Let's give him a minute. You want to kill me, don't you? Release him. Go on. Prove how strong you are. Do it for Ethan.
No, Rodrik. He's toying with you.
Your little brother had bigger balls than you. I came here to kill you, but now I realize it might be far more entertaining to watch Lud tear you to pieces. I never want to come back to this fucking shit stain of a holdfast. I have better things to do than to play wet nurse to you and Lud. So you'll settle this on your own. Last house standing wins. Otherwise, I'll kill you both and be done with it.
House Forrester will win this fight.
You're very confident for a man with no army and half a face. And one more thing. Can't leave a job half finished. Ready the horses. Not sure you'll have much luck finding other allies.
Innocent blood shed on Forrester lands. What would father think? Only a monster would do such a thing. The Boltons will pay for this. Arthur, oh, I'm so sorry.
I keep asking myself what we've done to deserve such hate.
The Whitehills started this. Ramsey Snow may have held the knife, but they're the ones who sharpened it.
I know it, my lord. I only hope you can put an end to it. The Glenmore Guard are gone. Ordered home by Ramsey. So much for having allies.
Ramsey says he's not taking sides anymore. He means to let the strongest house survive.
I intend that to be us, Duncan.
But can we even fight them? We don't have the numbers. We don't yet have Ryan back. And if Mira's right about an army from the south...
We'll worry about that after we get Ryan back. Once we've made the trade, then we can start to...
Where is he? Where is my brother?
My lady. My lady.
Let me through!
Elena.
Rodrik, tell me where he... Oh! No! No! Oh, no! No! Arthur, no! Arthur! It's my fault. I brought him into this. I asked him to help. He did this for me!
I'm so sorry, Elena. I know how much he meant to you.
He meant everything, Rodrik. He was my little brother. I was there the day he learned to hold a bow. He was so nervous, the father called him Quiver. And now to die, like this, tortured, mutilated,
He died as he lived. Bravely. As a man of the North.
He died in agony and for nothing. Look at him, Rodrik. There's hardly anything left of him.
Elena.
I'm sorry.
Let's get you someplace warm.
How do I do this, Rodrik? How do I keep going? Where do I find the strength?
Know that we'll have our justice someday.
Justice won't bring my brother back. You've been such a friend to me, Rodrik. Right from the very beginning. I should try to get some sleep. I'm not sure I'll be able to. But I don't know what else to do.
You're not alone, Elena. I'm here for you, whatever you need.
Thank you, Rodrik.
You are. I haven't seen you since the coronation feast. How many ships do you suppose it takes to move an army? Ships? Why in the world would you... Never mind. Mira, I'll be honest. I took an enormous risk, defying Marjorie to get you into that feast, and you thanked me by making a scene with Lord Andros in front of everybody. Marjorie saw, of course, and she knew exactly how you got there. Lord Andros is a threat to my family. He's plotting against them even as we speak. I believe you, but you called attention to yourself, Mira. And you angered Marjorie. Which is why it's not safe for me to be around you anymore. What? Mira, you're not the girl I knew at Highgarden. She'd never be so reckless. And now that Garibald and I are discussing marriage, I just can't risk being associated with you. Not anymore. You know how much I need this marriage. I won't do anything to jeopardize it. If you abandon me, who'll be there when you need someone? I don't know. Garibald, I suppose. I'm sorry, Mira. I truly am. Was it worth it, at least? Sacrificing so much for your family. They're still in very grave danger, I'm afraid. Well, I know you'll do everything in your power to protect them.
They'll be very grateful.
I better go before she sees me. She'll...
Mira Forrester!
Can I help you?
You need to come with me. Now.
Why would I?
Don't make this difficult.
Come on, Beska, listen. How can you still be angry at me?
Is that a joke? I had Dezor Zaraza in my hand, and you made me let him go.
You know why.
Yeah, you were afraid of disobeying the pretty little queen. You chose your prize over my one chance of revenge. And for what? There's no way this dragon queen comes through.
Everything I do now, it's for my family.
Oh yes, those wonderful people who exiled you. You once said I was all the family you needed. We should never have come here. This city. It only holds pain for me, Yasha. I was hoping to bury it all with Dezor's corpse. But you denied me that.
I...
Please, I don't want to talk about it again.
Yasha, you're back.
Uncle.
Let's collect our second sons and get out of here.
If you did as you were told, Daenerys should deliver.
Daenerys, huh? First names with the Queen now, are we?
Your Grace, my nephew has returned from his mission.
It seems you played your part in the taking of Meereen, Asha Forrester. Did you run into any trouble? Reports from the battle are muddled. Perhaps you can clear them up. Well, my time is short.
Nothing out of the ordinary, Your Grace. We fulfilled your orders.
To the letter, if reports are true. I hear you know how to follow orders, despite your friend's efforts to make you stray. You told me Asher was a man of integrity, Malcolm. Now I know you were telling the truth. You have proved yourself an honorable warrior. You have my gratitude. Unfortunately, I cannot spare my second sons.
What?
But Your Grace, the mission was a success.
I need every soldier to hold Meereen.
This is why you denied me my revenge? What did I tell you? She was never going to help us.
You promised me Croft and his second sons.
Which is why I'm not going to let you leave here empty-handed. In truth, we are not so different. We're both far from home. We've both suffered the loss of those we've loved. And we both struggle to do what's right.
That's high praise, Your Grace. I'm honored.
You've earned it. I cannot give you my sellswords, but I will give you the next best thing. This gold will be of use. Perhaps you can find the swords you need in Meereen.
Thank you, Your Grace.
We promise to put it to good use.
I'm sure you will. A new day is born in Meereen. The slaves have thrown off their collars. There are fighters among those who used to be bound.
On behalf of the Forresters and the Branfields, I thank you.
See that you are ready when I return to Westeros. I have other plans for you, Malcolm.
Plans for me, Your Grace?
Plans that will help House Forrester, I hope.
I would like you to stay and serve me. I have a task for you.
Your Grace, I am humbled. But I owe my allegiance to my family.
And they will be grateful for the Targaryen alliance you've helped forge.
I am honored you would ask me. Might I discuss it with my nephew first?
Do so. But let me know your answer soon.
You'd seriously consider staying in Essos?
I'm not sure. This is all rather sudden. If she does come to Westeros, we'd want Daenerys Targaryen on our side. You've made a good start with her. I could strengthen that bond. It's worth thinking about, you have to admit.
You're right, Uncle. The Mother of Dragons would make a powerful ally.
If she succeeds in taking the Iron Throne, she'll be the only ally we need. But whatever comes of this, we still need men who will fight for us now. The Queen thought we might find them here, among the newly freed.
Little Queen is right. Meereen holds plenty of killers, and I know the worst.
So what are we waiting for? Let's go get them.
I don't know, Asha. They're not like us. To them, killing is a sport. It's fun.
Let them have fun with the Whitehills, then. As long as they kill them, I don't care.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
I must talk further with the Queen. Don't get yourselves killed.
So, where exactly are we going?
Well, these fighters used to be slaves. If I had to guess, I'd say they'll be trying to live like masters.
You're freezing.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Someone has to keep watch.
Oh!
It's getting worse, isn't it?
But we're only about a few days out from the Antler River. We cross a bridge the first men built. And from there, we can try to find the North Grove. Right, Sylvie?
We're not going north. We're going south to join Mance and the rest of the Free Folk.
But look...
That was always the plan, Cotter.
I have to go to the North Grove. My family's depending on it.
Your family needs you to wander around in the snow until you get eaten by a direwolf.
Please, Sylvie. He knows what he's doing.
Does he now? Tell me then. How did my brother get that gash in his arm? You dressed his wound up well enough. But why'd he get hurt in the first place?
What does that have to do with the...
Hush, Cotter! I'm asking Fishface here.
Sylvie!
Don't Sylvie me. I want to hear it from him.
Some wildlings, free folk, mistook Cotter for a crow.
Can't imagine why.
We tried to reason with them and, well, things got out of hand.
Out of hand? From the look of him, he was nearly killed. Point is, you don't belong out here.
Sylvie, I've known Gadded a while now. He may not be one of us, but I trust him.
I've been waiting months for you, Cotter. And when you finally come home, it's with some crow who can barely build a fire. No, we don't need to die for him.
Me neither. Fucking North Grove isn't even real. And if it is, it's probably full of wolves and more wildlings.
Fens, probably. It is real. Lord Forrester believed it. And so do I.
And you're both idiots.
Finn, will you...
Just piss off.
Some leader you turned out to be.
You should listen to him. The further north you go, the more likely you'll never come back. It's just not worth it. Once Cotter's fit to travel, we head south. With or without you, Garrod.
Sylvie.
You need to rest. And we'll be wanting something to eat. I won't go far.
Oh, don't be angry, Garrod.
Why'd you even bring me here, Cotter? You said you'd take me to the North Grove.
Sylvie knows these woods better than I do. If anyone can find the North Grove, it's her. And besides, I couldn't just leave her. I won't do that, not again.
Then convince her to go with us. She's your sister.
Well, maybe she's right. Maybe you don't belong up here.
You don't mean that. So that's it. I can't head north without a guide.
I go where she goes. I'm sorry, Garrod.
What are you doing over here? There's a perfectly good fire.
I'm not going anywhere near those fucking wildlings.
Oh, come on. Just give them a chance.
I did. And look where it got us.
I'm sorry for getting you into this mess. Really.
Not your fault. I wanted to come. Just didn't know this is how it turned out.
Come on, Finn.
You'll freeze your ass off if you stay here.
Suppose you're right. May as well get warm before I die.
I wonder why she doesn't wear it.
Oh, this is that stuff Cotter was drinking.
Oh, well, it's not so bad. I wonder if she's ever seen an ice spider. Whew. Hope not.
You and your sister, you don't look much alike. The white hair and...
I know what you're getting at. So you may as well just say it.
I just wondered.
She was born like that.
My mother used to call her Little Moon. The rest of our village thought she was a bad omen.
The better of them stayed away from her. The worse?
Let's just say I'm glad to be rid of them.
Why were they afraid of your sister?
Same reason you southerners call us wildlings. Same reason you put up that wall to keep us out.
People are assholes.
What happened to your village? Did you leave?
Well, not by choice.
When Sylvie reached 2 years, they told my mother we weren't welcome anymore. She wasn't welcome.
I guess they all hoped she wouldn't survive long enough to get a name. But she's tough, Sylvie.
No way she wasn't going to make it.
Where's your mother now?
I don't know. Still back at the village for all I know.
She tried to send my sister away. Wrapped her up in furs and everything like a good mother would. I left that night when I heard.
How's your arm feeling?
Decent, I'd say. Why'd you ask?
Oh, you mean this one? Yeah, it's shit.
Whoa! Fucking hell. Could you have been any louder?
Sorry.
Never met a crow before. Sorry I almost killed you. Might have done you a favor, though. Plenty of things want to kill a crow up north. Giants, fens, shadow cats and ice spiders. And the White Walkers, of course. A spear sounds nice after all that, doesn't it?
They can try to kill me if they want. I won't let them.
I'm sorry. But that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Don't frighten our dinner away. Shit.
It's my turn.
Oh, really? You even know how to use that thing? You're not going to shoot me in the leg, are you?
I never miss.
You're right so far. You'll do nicely, little one.
Would that be enough?
You ever seen Cotter eat? We'll need another. Come on.
Ah, you're joking.
Maybe next time, Garrod. It's not much, but it'll last us. You're not half bad with a bow. Could come in handy. You ever lost anyone, Garrod? Someone you really cared about? Someone you thought you couldn't live without seeing ever again?
I lost my family. First my mother, then my sister and father.
So you know how it feels. Cotter and I, we lost everything too. And we nearly lost each other. I didn't think he'd make it back this time. And I won't risk losing him again. Not even for the North Grove.
You know something about it, don't you?
Only what I've heard. But don't get your hopes up. It's not worth it.
Please, Sylvie. I need to know.
A few years back, one of the Ice River clans set out to find it. They'd heard stories that the cold couldn't touch it, that it's safe even in the dark of winter. So they'd set out, all full of hope. And none of them ever returned.
Do you believe the stories?
Oh, I forgot. You southerners don't believe in anything you can't see with your eyes.
Garrod! Help!
Cotter!
What the fuck?
This looks like the place.
This is definitely the place.
So, who are we dealing with exactly?
Pit fighters. Two go in, one comes out, day after day. No rules but kill. Anyone who can survive that is capable of anything. They're crazed savages. But one pit fighter is worth any 10 cell swords. If you can convince them to fight for you. And that's not going to be easy. Don't expect to charm them or reason with them. If we're very lucky, we'll walk out with our heads.
I've been fighting alongside cell swords for years, Beska. I know how to talk to killers.
Understand, these aren't soldiers. They're animals you unleash.
Must make you feel pretty good, seeing the masters overthrown.
They're not gone. They're just on their knees. And when they get back to their feet, they'll be more dangerous than ever.
What the fuck?
Trust me, you don't want to get involved, Russia.
Your friends have been busy.
Let's hope our heads don't end up here. The servants and guards of this house, they killed them all.
Why? Some of these must have been slaves too.
Because they felt like it. That's a good enough reason for this lot. Oh, one last thing. They're not fond of strangers.
I can handle this.
Oh? After you, then.
Well, if it isn't Beskar, the fucking basilisk.
We just want to talk to Amaya.
You don't want to be in here, little man. You best go back the way you came before I decide to eat you. I'll start with your eyeballs. Fucking juicy when they pop. And then I'll pull out your little bones to pick my teeth with.
You sure you have room for me? You seem pretty well fed already.
My master only ever fed me when I won. I won a lot. Now, you've got to the count of three to turn around and walk away. One, two. I like this one. Hey, Amaya! Company!
Is that a pit?
Yeah, some masters couldn't get enough of the fighting, so they built their own private pits, where things could get really nasty.
That's Amaya.
Keep your cock in your pants, little brother. She's likely to chop it off.
Well, hello there.
Not many people get past the beast. You must need something very badly. So, out with it. Before I decide not to let you leave,
my name is Asher Forrester. I've traveled all the way from Westeros.
I'd suggest you go back there. It's not safe here for outsiders.
Amaya, please.
Please what? I had a friend once, the Basilisk, but she died a long time ago.
I earned my freedom.
You walked out on me, on all of us. Fighting side by side, we were goddesses of the pits. But when you're born trash, I guess you can't help going back to the gutter.
You have a problem with her? Deal with me.
So, what is it that you want? Why shouldn't we rip you to pieces and feed you to the beast?
enemies in Westeros are powerful and bloodthirsty. Worse than your masters ever were. I need fearless soldiers to crush them.
You think we're sellswords? We don't fight other people's wars. We are pit fighters, artists who paint in blood.
That was yesterday. Fighting pits have been closed.
You're all free now. Free to do what you want.
Don't you see that?
Yes, we are free. Why would we follow another? We don't have masters anymore. Why would we follow anyone ever again?
The life you've led here is over. I've met the Mother of Dragons. She won't open the pits again. If you want to fight, we offer gold and glory.
Amaya, trust me. He's got enough gold for all of you.
You want to lead pit fighters? You have to earn their respect first.
We don't know who you are until we see you bleed.
You're gonna have to show them you can fight.
All right. Who?
His name is Bloodsong. He's vicious, fearless, and fast.
I've never seen him before.
Take a good look then.
He's the man who's going to kill your boy.
We'll have to kill him. It'd be a shame to waste such a talented fighter. Perhaps if I just subdued him.
No one has ever subdued him.
Right.
Well, suppose I better get this over with.
So what are you supposed to be? With your little axe? Your pretty blonde beard? I'd sooner bend you over to fuck than fight you.
Thanks for noticing the beard.
Well, come on! Let's see how you die!
Goodbye, dying there.
Yeah? You have a dying wish? This ought to be good.
Will you return to Westeros and kill as many Whitehills as you can?
No. I'll spend all your gold on the finest of whores.
Hey! I need those!
You'll fight with the weapons we give you.
You all see this cockless Westerosi? He's come to order us to battle, like our masters did! I kill no man because another orders me to. I kill a man because it pleases me! Let me show you how we dance in Marine.
Look, this wasn't my choice. I'm not here to kill anyone.
Well, we all know that's true.
Oh. That's not what I meant.
Choose a weapon and try not to die. Only one of you leaves the pit alive. May the best fighter win!
The best would be me! Are you ready, Westerosi? Yours will be a beautiful death! Isn't that something you'd like to say? Hear that, boy? We cannot let the crowd go wanting!
I think I can, actually.
For that, you die slow. Would it help if I stood still?
Maybe.
Son of a whore! See if you're still smiling after I break your face!
Surprised you can lift it.
The masters who once held your chains decided who lived and who died. But as you can see, I'm not here to be your master. You're true warriors. Warriors I admire and respect. You deserve better than this. You deserve more than to die for someone else's entertainment. Fight with me and you will have glory and gold. If you've got the balls to follow me, we will set sail at dawn. And to those too craven to join me, to hell with you!
I knew them!
What are those things?
Oh, God! Over here! Over here!
They won't die!
Anything can be killed!
They're everywhere! We make for the North Crow! stick together!
Run! Now! I hope you're right about this, Garrett. Your Grace.
You're familiar with my brother's chambers, aren't you? Certainly you've been here before. You looked rather confused when you came in, as if you didn't know where you were.
Yes, Your Grace.
I'd like to think we can be honest with one another. However, you're quite the curiosity, aren't you? You profess to be loyal to the Crown, yet you're not very loyal to Lady Marjorie.
Have I displeased you, Your Grace?
I've heard things. I understand you've been quite busy. Tell me, do you consider yourself an honest, loyal handmaiden? One can never tell with you northern girls, assuming an honest person exists in King's Landing.
It hasn't been easy, Your Grace, but I've done what I've needed to do.
Haven't we all? I've done my best to keep an open mind about people like you. Yet, Lucan tells me you invited yourself to Tommen's coronation party. How exactly did that happen?
I meant no harm, Your Grace. I had a personal matter to attend to.
A personal matter? I'm told you used another girl to talk your way in. You're not above using people to get what you want. Good. Why would you be so reckless as to risk your neck for what?
My family is still very much at risk, Your Grace. It was crucial I attend.
Your family. Sometimes that's a convenient lie we tell ourselves. When I suspect your issue with Lord Andros played a part in it. You've been such a busy little handmaiden. I assume Lady Marjorie knew nothing of this.
No, Your Grace.
This wasn't the first time you've hidden the truth from her. You've no qualms about lying to her, have you?
Only when I must, Your Grace.
I think we both know it's more often than that. Perhaps I mistook your northern stubbornness for ignorance, but now I see there's more to you. You're a cunning girl, and perhaps you can help me.
Your Grace?
You're quite friendly with my brother Tyrion. I need you to speak with him before the trial begins. I want to know who he intends to call as a witness on his behalf. Consider it a favor to the Crown, for which we will all be grateful.
I guess I could, Your Grace.
It won't be easy. Tyrion is devious. You'll have to hide your intentions, otherwise he'll tell you nothing. You may prove to be a useful little bird to me, assuming you do as you're told. In return, I'll take care of your problem with Lord Andros.
Thank you, Your Grace.
I never liked the man anyway, and I doubt anyone will miss him.
You think we hired this boat for nothing?
No, I don't know. That was a rousing speech you gave, little brother. But who knows how much they heard.
They say your homeland is fat and prosperous. An orchard ripe for plucking.
We'll take what we want and kill anyone who stands in our way.
There's no spoils without victory.
Don't worry about that. Victory is all we know.
I'll show them their beds.
I'll be there in a moment. Go on.
Glad you made it.
What choice did I have? You denied me an honorable death, so I must find one in Westeros.
Vesco wasn't exaggerating.
Malcolm, you're here!
And you've found your soldiers. Ironwrath will be glad of your return. You came through for them. Just as I knew you would.
What does Daenerys want from you?
She has a mission for me. But beyond that, she's told me nothing. If I can, I'd like to help her reclaim the Iron Throne. Imagine what an ally she'd be to House Forrester if she succeeds. Living here has made a better man of you, nephew. Perhaps the same will be true for me.
Thank you, Uncle.
I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for you. You've guided me well.
You are your father's son, Asher. For all your differences, he would be proud. I'll send a raven ahead to Ironwrath to let Rodrik know you sail for Westeros with, sellswords. My thoughts will be with you in the fight to come. Asher. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Casting off!
Take this. It'll help loosen his tongue. But be careful. He's a tricky little bastard. If he figures out who sent you, he'll tell you nothing. I'll be listening to every word you say.
Oh, I ask for brawn, they send me a handmaiden. Well, you're here. You might as well come in. Let me guess. Your family is in grave danger, and you've come seeking my help?
Not that I'd be of much use to you.
As you can see, I'm at a bit of a disadvantage.
I brought you a gift.
Wine. You know the way to my heart. And you didn't even have to hide it. Doesn't smell poisoned.
Poisoned?
Cersei would love nothing more than to save herself the trouble of a trial.
You don't expect me to drink alone, do you?
They never let anyone in to see me.
I suppose I'll have just a little.
Ah, true girl of the North. Some things are worth dying for.
So, why are you here?
It's rather unusual for a handmaiden to visit the Black Cells.
Cersei.
I have to admit, I've always admired your honesty, but I suspect there's more to you than one might imagine.
This is all a ruse, isn't it?
Sorry?
You're coming here.
We both know you have an ulterior motive.
You've come to set me free.
It's the perfect plan.
No one would suspect it of you.
I'm afraid not, unfortunately.
Unfortunate for us both. So, tell me. Cersei sent you, didn't she?
I know I'm not wrong.
She left me no choice.
She never does. At least you had the courage to tell me the truth.
I told you not to run your mouth! Stupid girl. You're acting a fool.
Let me handle this. We're not done talking.
You heard the girl. Go.
Imp.
What did my sister expect you would learn?
Who will testify on your behalf?
She's using you, and will continue to do so until you no longer prove useful.
I know exactly what I'm doing.
Oh, clearly. Which is why you're here, doing her bidding. And what would Lady Marjorie make of your new friendship with my sister? I doubt she'd be pleased. Assuming she doesn't dismiss you immediately.
To be honest, I don't care what Lady Marjorie thinks of me.
I thought you were smarter than that.
Without her protection, you're in a very precarious position.
What should I tell Cersei?
She knows the answer better than anyone. No one will testify for me. She's already seen to that. That is the truth of it. Not that it will help you.
I appreciate your honesty, Lord Tyrion.
And I yours, Lady Mira. Although I doubt my sister will.
Enough of this nonsense! You're wasting my time! Out! Now!
I wish you well, Lady Mira. Be careful who you trust.
Must you leave?
Sorry. Didn't mean to wake you.
You didn't sleep, did you?
Neither did you.
We haven't slept much at all these last few weeks. I hope you don't have any regrets. About this. About us.
I've never felt more certain about anything.
I'm glad. I wasn't sure if you... with all that's happened. What will we do now? Now that we're... what we are.
We'll be married. And no one will be able to keep us apart. Not Gryff. Not his father. Not Ramsey Snow.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Rodrik? Oh! I'm sorry. I thought you were alone.
Good morning, Talia.
Hello, Elena. Oh, I didn't realise you two were... I mean, I didn't realise she was...
It's all right, Talia. Come in.
I really am sorry. It's just, this is urgent, Rodrik. And...
It's all right. I can go. You two need to speak. I'll see you soon, I hope.
I'm listening.
Last night, I couldn't... I was having nightmares. So I...
Go on, Talia.
I went back there. To the grove. And someone was there.
What do you mean?
Look.
This is a report. How many fighting men we have. Where Gryff and the Whitehill garrison are being held. It even talks about Elena.
I know. It's everything. I couldn't believe it. If I hadn't seen it with my own eyes...
You said you saw someone. Who?
Someone we trusted.
Talia, I need to know who it was.
He's like family, Rodrik. But it doesn't matter. He's a traitor. He endangered our house. You have to deal with him like you would any other man. I'm sure he had his reasons, but no reason is good enough.
Talia, I'll do the right thing. You know me.
I do know you. That's why I need you to promise. Promise me you'll kill him, Rodrik. Anyone who would betray us like this deserves to die. I'm asking you, as your sister, make him pay.
I'm lord of this house, Talia. It's my job to deliver justice, not vengeance. I can't promise to kill a man before I've heard him out.
You know what he's done. That should be enough.
Talia, please.
Come with me. He's in the Great Hall.
Go get the guards.
Oh, my lord, you scared the bloody daylights out. What's that?
You tell me.
You don't scare me, Rodrik. I've known you since you were a boy. Back when you still had a spine.
Why, Roiland? Why did you do it?
Your father was the greatest lord I've ever known. But you... you've brought this house to ruin. You pushed me to this, Rodrik. You brought it upon yourself.
Don't you dare start making excuses.
Excuses? Are you that naive? Look at you, Rodrik. You're weak. You're weak. Just like Ethan was. Making Duncan his sentinel.
Ethan was a boy.
Ethan was a fool. And you've been making fool choices too since the day you crawled off that corpse cart. Bungling your betrothal to Elena. Doesn't matter how either of you feel. Lord Glenmore will never let you marry her now. Letting Gryff force you to the ground without a shred of dignity. Going to High Point without any soldiers, despite my every warning. Hell, you even managed to get Arthur killed.
Enough, Roiland!
You've had every opportunity to save this family, but you've squandered them all. Your father would be ashamed. Hate me for it, but it's the bloody truth.
You betrayed us all, Roiland. My father included.
I've held true to what I believed, which is more than I can say for you.
The only thing that matters is that you swore an oath to all.
I swore to your father. I'd swear to Asher if he were here. But you're a cripple who can barely hold a sword. Asher knows how to act. All you do is limp between defeats.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Finally showing some spine.
Rodrik, it's Gryff. He's gone.
Somebody set him free. Was this your doing?
They were going to ambush you at the trade. I just saved your life.
But Ryan... Roiland, how could you?
This was his doing. Just sentence me and be done with it. Kill me. And Asher dies too.
Please, Rodrik.
What do you mean?
I know Lud's plans. Spare my life. And I'll tell you everything.
Perhaps we should hear him out.
He's only saying that to save himself.
You must decide, my lord.
You must be loving this, Duncan.
I'll spare your life. Now talk.
Mira cost Lud his army. He's desperate to strike back. He's going to ambush Asher the moment he makes landfall.
No!
You must protect Asher. Protect the true lord of this house.
Take this traitor away.
Get your hands off me!
What Roiland said. We have to warn Asher.
We can't, not if he's at sea.
My lord, what do we do?
Prepare the horses.
We're gonna defend my brother.
Smell that. We're almost there, Eske. Let's have a look.
Come on, break it up!
Save your lovemaking for below deck.
They listen to you. Barely. But what happens if your lord brother decides he's the one in charge once we're at Ironwrath? Do you expect them to follow his orders? Or will it be you commanding them? They don't know him. A lord sounds an awful lot like a master.
Rodrik. He's the lord of the house, and he's been bred for it.
I understand, but these men and women have journeyed here to follow you, not him.
Oh, you'll see when you meet him. Doesn't matter if he can't fight like he used to. All men learn to love Rodrik.
That's odd. Port's quiet. No guards. Hardly any ships.
Maybe they're all off fighting one of your king's wars.
Could be.
Or could be we'll have a fight on our hands. I'll let the others know.
Right. Oh, this couldn't be easy, could it?
So, this is Westeros.
Ugly and small.
Fucking freezing, too.
I said you'd be paid. I never said you'd be warm.
Asha, thank the gods you've made it back.
Good to see you, my lord.
Hope you're ready for a fight.
Lord knows you're coming. He sent men to intercept you. We need to hurry.
Been stuck on a boat for weeks. Could use a good fight.
What?
Open!
Asha, no!
It's been a while since I killed any Whitehills.
Looks like it's up to us! Asha!
Raise the gate! They've got us outnumbered! Oh, shit! We have to get out of here! Holding it. One of us has to stay. Let me save your life and our house.
Iron from ice, brother.
Iron from ice. I'll hold them off. But my lord, you can't.
Asher is your new lord.
Yes, my lord.
Rodrik!
Go!
Ah!